Hello students, class 11, how are you all? I think all of you are well and fine and safe also. And this is your first class, okay, of this session. At first, I want to congratulate to all of you. Congratulations for your good result and welcome to our class 11 classroom. Okay, this is your maths class. And I will be taking your trigonometry, coordinate geometry, and then calculus of for class 11 and class 12. Other parts are there. And class 11, you will get algebra part also, and set modern algebra, set theory, relation mapping. That also, Shubha ma'am will be taking that part, and I will be taking this part. Okay, so. Let's start our new chapter. Okay. In class 11, marks divisions of mathematics. This is quite different from class 10 mathematics. Here you will get 1 marks questions, that is MCQ part, and 2 marks question, that is SAQ part, and then you will get 4 marks questions and then 5 marks questions. Only 4 types questions you will get. 1 mark, 2 marks, 1 mark obviously MCQ, 1 marks, 2 marks, SAQ, and 4 marks, and then 5 marks. Okay, I think all of you have taken the subjects willingly. Okay. Now this class, this session is for class 11, trigonometry first class. Okay, and in trigonometry, class 10, already you have completed the trigonometry part up to height and distance. Okay, that means you have idea about trigonometrical angles. Now here, this chapter is trigonometry, topic measurement of trigonometrical angles. Measurement of trigonometrical angles. Okay, so before starting this trigonometrical angles, let me say something about geometrical angles. What is the difference between geometrical angle and trigonometrical angle? Okay, when two lines, say OX and OP, these two lines, OX and OP, these two lines, when they meet at one point, then one angle is formed. In normal geometry, we normally say that when two lines meet each other at one point, at that particular point one angle is formed. Okay, one angle is formed, and this angle, or normally we measure this angle anti-clockwise direction. And if we start from here, so anti-clockwise direction, we can go up to this. That means total 0 degree to 360 degree, that geometrical angle we can draw. Geometrically we can draw 0 degree to 360 degree. That means with the help of protractor, we can draw up to 180 degree, 272 degree, 350 degree, 360 degree up to. And all these angles, these are drawn anti-clockwise direction. These are drawn anti-clockwise directions. This is geometrical angle. And trigonometrical angle, there is no definite value. There is no definite value. Geometrical angles, all these angles are always positive. Why this is positive? Coming, this point. And trigonometrical angle, there is, the angle may be positive or may be negative. Okay, so what is the main difference? Geometrical angle, 0 degree to 360 degree, and trigonometrical angle, there is no definite value. Got it? And geometrical value, geometrical angle always positive, but trigonometrical angle may be positive or may be negative. Okay. Now, what is positive angle? An angle formed by anti-clockwise rotation is a positive angle. An angle formed by anti-clockwise rotation is a positive angle. This is the definition of positive angle in trigonometrical angles. That means OX, this is one line. OX, this is one line. And OX, this is the initial arm. When we have started about the angle, the initial arm, final arm, this language we know. So initial arm is OX, and OP is the final arm. That means when OP coincides with OX, then there is no angle. That means OP generally it comes to this point by anti-clockwise movement. That means if I draw the line, say OX from here and OX from this point to this point, that means anti-clockwise movement, then OP, this is the, normally we call this is final arm, and this line, since this line rotate, this line is known as generating line. Since this line is moving, this line is known as generating lines. Okay, so this angle, what is the definition? An angle formed by anti-clockwise rotation is a positive angle. Okay, that means from OX to OP, when it moves anti-clockwise direction, this is positive angle. Okay, similarly, when the angle from OX to OP, from this direction if it moves, that means it is clockwise direction. So this will be the negative angle. This is the definition of negative angle. An angle generated by clockwise rotation is a negative angle. An angle generated clockwise direction rotation or direction is a negative angle. That means this OX to OP, this part is negative angle and this part is positive angle. Always that means what we can say from this: positive angle always anti-clockwise direction measured, and negative angle always clockwise direction measured. Okay, this is the definition of positive angle and negative angle. But in trigonometry, we can translate the negative angle to the positive angle. How? We can add 360 degrees. We can add 360 degrees. So minus 135, the question is translate minus 135 degree to positive angle. How can we draw this one? Minus 135 degree? Simply minus 135 degree plus 360 degree will get 225 degree, that is positive angle. So normally if we can draw 225 degree, that is equivalent to minus 135 degree. Okay. Next is, system of measuring angles. What are the system of measuring angles? There are three system of measuring angles. One is sexagesimal, that already you have done in class 10. Number two, centesimal, that you have not done. Next is circular, that also you have done. Sexagesimal, that is the English version. Centesimal, this is the French version. And this is circular. Circular means always we will write here in terms of pi. That already we have done in class 10. Okay, now one right angle in this system 90 degrees, sexagesimal system. Sexagesimal system. Okay, this system 190 degree is divided into 90 equal parts, and each such part is called 1 degree. Okay, that means 90 degree is divided into 90 equal parts. 90 degree is divided into 90 equal parts. And each part is known as 1 degree. Okay. That, and again 1 degree is divided into 90 equal parts. Sorry. 1 degree is divided into 60 equal parts. Again, 1 degree is divided into 60 equal parts, and each part is called 1 minute. Each part is called 1 minute, and here each part is called 1 degree. Okay, and again 1 minute is divided into 60 equal parts, and each such part is called 1 second. Okay, so one right angle, what we get exactly? One right angle is equal to 90 degree, 1 degree is equal to 60 minute, and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. This is the sexagesimal system. Okay, next, centesimal system. What is centesimal system? Okay, centesimal system, in this system centesimal system, in this system 90 degrees divided in, obviously always we will consider only 90 degree angle here also. So 90 degree angle here divided into 100 equal parts. 90 degree is divided into 100 equal parts, and each such part is known as one grade. Is known as one grade, and normally we write this one grade in this way. And again one grade is divided, this is known as one grade. Again one grade is divided into 100 equal parts, and again each such part is called centesimal minute, that is 1 minute. Centesimal minute. So one right angle is equal to 100 grades. 1 grade is equals to 100 minute, and 1 minute is equals to 100 seconds. This is the centesimal part. Okay, and next is circular part. Circular part, you know it very well. Circular part, already you have done the previous class, circular system, but still I will explain it again coming with the next video. Okay.